Paris. City of love, romance, and dreams. So they say. I used to say it too. But ever since that day, the day of the murder, I've always associated my beloved Paris with death. I was at home having a bath when my editor called.
Caller, get your ass over to the Palais Royal now. You got an interview. With Pierre Karchan. Yes, the Pierre Karchan. No photos, so leave your gear at home. He has for you personally. Don't ask me why. Anyhow, this could be big, so if he makes a pass, don't forget. Just smile, say yes, and keep taking notes.
So charming and so very apt. Pierre Karchan was a media king, a national hero, and one of the most infamous adulterers in Europe. He and his wife Imelda were just one step down from royalty. Whoa, I hate mimes, but unless you humor them, they don't go away. Here I was, the palace of the media king and the ice queen. I pressed the doorbell and set in motion a chain of events which would change my life forever.
Yes, what is it?
Madame, my name is Nico Collard. I'm here to see Monsieur Karchan.
Come up, we're on the first floor.
Madame Karchan, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yes, I'm sure.
The Ice Queen was certainly living up to her reputation. Will you be staying for the interview?
Mademoiselle, I know little of my husband's business affairs, and I care even less. I certainly have no intention of watching him pore over yet another pretty little journalist.
Pretty? You're too kind, madame.
Ah, the talented and very beautiful Mademoiselle Collard. Such a pleasure to meet you at last.
Monsieur Karchan, I am honored.
Oh, I'm sure you are.
Call me Pierre, please. But I do not flatter you idly. I was a friend of your father. He was a great man.
My father? He never mentioned.
He and I were very close. And then his death. So tragic. I must... Imelda, your damned cat's in my study again. Another Ming vase, I suppose. Excuse me for one moment, my dear girl.
You journalists are getting younger each year.
Perhaps it's the rest of the world getting older, madame. That was no cat.
My God! What? Monsieur Karchan!
He's dead. I must call the police. You'd better stay here.
There was a man. It was the mime. Do you think he...
Well, I believe we can rule out suicide, don't you?
No wonder they called her the Ice Queen. She would have been top of my list of suspects if I hadn't seen the attacker myself. And if I hadn't come across a couple of murders just like this already. One of the most important men in Europe, murdered And here was I, Nico Coulard, alone at the scene of the crime. Should I wait for the cops? Or start my own investigation? It was a no-brainer. Mimes and guns don't usually go together, but I had an idea that this was no ordinary mime. I'd come across this murderer before, and written about him. The costume killer, at least that's what I'd called him. His lifeless eyes stared blankly at nothing. I closed his eyes. It was the least I could do for the poor fellow. Some people hate searching corpses for clues. Me, I'm okay with it. Reminds me of an old boyfriend. Cachon had been shot. In his pocket, I found a ticket stamped Bateau de la Conciergerie. Taking the ticket meant I tampered with the evidence. There was no going back now. It was one of my hair clips. My favorite, in fact. It must have fallen when I was knocked down. You had to hand it to the Ice Queen. She sure knew her fabrics. A small round piece of glass had been cut out of the pane. This was a professional job. This was the work of the mime. Unless the cat was in on it too. I didn't want to cut myself and leave blood on the glass. Call me old-fashioned, but I like to keep my DNA to myself. Your original 18th century high security window handle. The killer must have used a ladder to reach the window. He was long gone. Guess he folded that ladder up, popped it in his pocket and took it with him. A bust of Pierre Cachon, humble servant of La France. The bookcase was filled with obscure first editions. Pierre Cachon again. His eyes seemed to follow me around the room. The police could turn up at any minute. Somewhere there were clues to the murder, and I needed to find them. A fine Baroque door. It would look great in my apartment. The door was locked. A medieval pageant. Original, no doubt. The tapestry must have cost a fortune. A Louis XIV table with an antique cloth. Imelda had taste. But hey, with a husband that rich, taste is easy. A beautiful cloth had been draped over the table. It was embroidered with an unusual cross. I reckoned that cloth might just turn out to be useful. There was a tiny hole in the tabletop. Part of the inlay had been chipped away. Even my fingernail wouldn't fit into such a small hole. Aha! Nico, you are just so damn good at this stuff. A key had been hidden in a secret compartment. A modern key. Instead of comforting Imelda, I was ransacking her flat. Why? Because there was something going on here, and I had to get answers before the cops arrived. And hey, she'd been rude to me, so she had it coming. A key. Maybe a safe key. It was a tube of acrylic paint. French ultramarine. Just the colour I was after for my bathroom.
I'm sorry, I have to go. Someone is...
Young lady, what are you doing?
Oh, this paint. It's my favourite colour.
For God's sake, keep the damn stuff.
Even the telephone was antique. Never trust anyone who owns a phone like that. There was no one I needed to phone. Not until I had solved this case. Imelda looked shocked, but still every bit as hostile.
Excuse me, madame.
Yes?
I am so sorry for your loss, madame.
No, you're not. You're a journalist. Journalists don't feel sorry.
Not true.
We shall see.
Why did your husband send for me? What did he want to discuss?
I have no idea. His business was his business.
He never told you anything?
No, and frankly, I preferred it that way.
How did your husband know my father?
I have no idea.
You didn't know him? Thierry Coulard?
Pierre knew a lot of people I didn't know, most of them women.
Why would a mime want to kill your husband?
Pierre had plenty of enemies. Half the husbands in Paris for a start. This is quite a scoop for you. I suppose you're already inventing the headlines.
Just because I am a journalist.
Don't patronise me. You're all cut from the same cloth. Do you have any moral sense at all?
Yes, that's why I do this job.
You do it to see your name in print.
As if. My editor gets the byline, I just do the work.
Well, don't expect my sympathy.
The police will be here soon, madame. Is there anybody you would like me to contact? Family, friends?
No, I have no family. Pierre and I were... He was all I had, really. Not much, was it? The dutiful wife? That was my role. He never talked, never let me in.
I know one thing, madame.
What?
If you want to find out who killed your husband, then you let me do the job, not the police.
Why? How do I know I can trust you?
Because you have no choice. The police will take weeks, in which time your own life may be in danger.
What?
Believe me, this killer has struck before, and he will strike again. Who is to know that you are not next on his list?
I don't know.
All I need is a few more minutes to look around before the police come.
You really do have a moral sense, don't you? I trust so few people, and I share your low opinion of the police. Here, take this. It's the key to the drawing room next to the library at the end of the hall. It was Pierre's room. I rarely went in there. I couldn't. I was too scared of what I might find.
Thank you. I promise you won't regret this.
Imelda had talent, but I certainly wasn't going to tell her that.
Now we were getting somewhere.
The sofa was antique. For one horrible moment, I had an image of a naked cochon wriggling around on it with a young journalist. Oh!